Hello everybody, Jordan Nelson here. Today we are talking about how to film a first look by yourself with one single camera. Let's get started. So before we hopped in here, I wanted to draw your attention to the links in the description below. There's just different resources, the gear that I use, 10% off Soundstripe. Soundstripe is a music licensing website that I use for my wedding film, so you can get 10% off your first purchase if you use the code Jordan Nelson, all caps, all one word, going through that link that I have in the description down there. So if you're interested, check that out. And last but not least, a beginner's guide to wedding filmmaking. There's a link in the description below. It's a PDF guide I created to help you beginners out in the wedding filmmaking world. So if you click that link, there's more information on that. It may apply to you, it may not. So check that out, it might be a good resource for you to continue learning. All right, so I'm done with all the business stuff. We're done there. Hopping into first looks. How do you film a first look by yourself with one camera? So I've done it a bunch of different ways, but I think I've kind of learned the ones that are the most and least effective. So you may disagree with me on the best way to do it, but this is what I do. This is kind of what I've come up with. So let's draw up some of these plays here. So because couples do their first looks differently every single time, we're gonna go through a few different scenarios on how this would work out. There are different space constraints and things like that. Okay, so let's say we have the groom posted up right here facing this direction. I'm usually standing right about here. I have a shot of the groom waiting in anticipation, waiting for her to come up behind her. And the bride is walking down, standing right here, looking at the groom. Now, typically, I have the groom in focus and the bride out of focus, but you could also switch it up as well, have him out of focus, her in focus. Or you could always walk over and get a shot of the bride close up for a second and then go back. Whatever you want to do. But what I've done in the past is I've stayed there while the groom has turned around, or while the bride has gotten to the groom, tapped on the shoulder, and he's turned around. I've stayed there, and guess what that shot gets me? The back of the groom's head and an over-the-shoulder shot of the bride's face, as long as the groom isn't blocking her. That is not the most ideal shot. You don't want to stay there, which I've done in the past, and I don't think it's the best way to do things. When the groom turns around, either when the bride goes all the way up to the groom, and turns, or if he just turns where he's at and then looks at her. I say there are a couple good options. One is probably better than the other, in my opinion. So the first option is going along with the groom as he's turning over his left shoulder. So you wanna make sure that the groom turns over the shoulder where you and the photographers are standing, because if he turns over the opposite shoulder, you're missing that entire turn. You wanna see the entirety of the moment and the reaction, so you don't wanna miss him turning as well. So have him turn over his left shoulder if that's where you're at. And then I have my glide cam, so I move along with him and I'm shooting in this direction, and then I just kind of stay along this 180 degrees. Now the thing with that is that you're getting basically the profile of both of them when they're looking at each other, which isn't the best for getting the entirety of someone's reaction. You're just kind of getting the side of each of their faces. So what I think is a better way to do this is before he even turns around, I go ahead and get over here. So I make sure that I get this shot right here and make sure that I get the shot of, you know, the bride in the background being ready, and I'm like, hey, wait, hold up. I need to make sure that I get here so that when he turns around, I have a great shot of his reaction. The reason why that's the most important is because this is the first time he has seen her in her dress. He hasn't been allowed to see her in her dress at all, hasn't been allowed to see the dress at all whatsoever on her or not. So this is kind of a big moment. She's excited for it, he's excited for it. So I wanna make sure that initial reaction, I make sure I have a good shot of the groom. I've missed that many times. So now I wanna make sure that I am in the right position to get his face after he turns around. But then after that initial reaction, when he's looking at her, I wanna make sure that I am getting both of their reactions, because this is the first time she's seen him too. So I wanna make sure I can kind of get over here and shoot at the bride, and then the middle to kind of get them together, because at some point here they're gonna be together. They're gonna either meet in the middle, or they're already gonna be together if she tapped him on the shoulder for him to turn. But just make sure that you have that clear shot of the groom's face, groom's reaction, and not just like the back of his head. The second best thing I would say is to have them both as he turns around, both of their profiles, so you can see both of their reactions a little bit. But for me, I think the groom's initial reaction is the most important. And then you can kind of go side to side along this 180 degree line over here. Just make sure that you're cognizant of the photographers as well, because if there's one photographer or two photographers, you need to make sure that you're communicating. If you're going to be going back and forth in here, they apply R2. They're directing photographer here, shooting in opposite directions. So you want to make sure that you're not getting in their way. That's one thing too, if you have two cameras or a second videographer, makes it easier to get both reactions. But because you're shooting with one camera, you kind of have that limitation on having to kind of pick and choose which shot is the best, the most appropriate at that time. Now backing up a little bit with that scenario, I like to be here so I can see the groom's reaction. You might also want to be a little bit back here as well to get an over the shoulder of the bride. That might be a good shot too, but just make sure that if she goes all the way up to him, and then he turns around, that the bride isn't like blocking the groom's face or reaction. So you want to make sure that you're maybe a little off to the side a bit more so that you can see his face and you don't miss that. If they really are close together in here, getting more profile might just be what you need to do because they're so close. But he'll probably back up once they kind of see each other for a sec so he can see her dress. So he can kind of look at it and take it in, and she might do a twirl or something. And that's a great shot to kind of get an over the shoulder of the bride and then a shot of the groom's face when he's like, wow, that's a really pretty dress. Now here's another scenario that is pretty common, is if the bride is chilling on the top of some stairs. No, she's not in jail. She's at the top of stairs. I'm not an artist. So in that case, same thing. I have the shot of the groom, and then I have an out of focus or maybe in focus shot of the bride, maybe get both of them. I've switched it up before. But then if you want to get the groom's reaction, it's typically pretty tight quarters where there are stairs. Now it might be a wide open expanse, which would be great, but if she's either going to come all the way down or stay up there while he turns around and looks up at her, I still want to be able to get his reaction. So before he turns around, I want to make sure I say, hey, wait up. I run up the stairs. I get right here. There's probably going to be a photographer up here too. If there's two photographers, one up here, maybe one at the bottom of the stairs, or just one, they're probably going to end up being up there with you as well. Because I want to be up here to get over her shoulder and get the groom's reaction. Especially if she's not going to go all the way down to him and tap his shoulder. But as is common, if she does go all the way down there, you can kind of follow a little bit down the stairs. And then as he turns, get his reaction. And then you can kind of do that 180. Now, I just want to make sure I can kind of get everything on the screen here for you to see, but it might look like that you're really, really, really close to the bride and groom. That is not necessarily what you want. So if we back up here, when the bride and groom come together, right here, and they're right here, and they're talking, and they're getting to see each other for the first time, you don't want to be right up in their face. Because they're having personal conversations with each other. It's the first time they've seen each other. Really personal, special, intimate moment for them. You wanna be capturing it, but you don't wanna be in their face because that might make them uncomfortable because they're not just posing for photos or a video shot or anything like that. They are relating with each other at that time. So that's way different than being in their face to have them kiss during a video shot or something. So make sure that you're giving them distance. Once they have come together and he's looking at her in her dress and they're talking, just capture it, but stay out of their face. Let them have their moment. And then even after you get some shots and get everything that you need, let them just keep talking. Those kind of shots are great anyways, but they give them some time. Don't just say like, okay, done, we gotta go, next thing. Let them just be together. And then if they turn to you and be like, okay, we're good, that usually means you're good to go to move on to the next thing. I hope that was helpful. Maybe gave you some options on how to best shoot the first look with one camera by yourself. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know in the comments below. Would love to hear from you. Or if you have anything you'd like to add, maybe other ways that you shoot first looks, maybe other tips that you've learned, please go ahead and add those in the comments below. And if you're new here, consider subscribing. I have a lot more videos just like this on the channel on wedding filmmaking, video creation, all that stuff. So if you're into that, consider subscribing. Would love to have you here. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. See y'all in the next video.